Hi there, and welcome to another tutorial. This time we're doing the original Atari 2600 controller, and it's a very simple design. We just have to take out four screws on the bottom here, and you use a simple Phillips screwdriver for that. And now that you have the four screws out, we can just put those to the side. And then we'll just peel this apart. It comes in two pieces. So you have the top piece here and then the bottom piece with the circuit board. And you can see it's a very rudimentary circuitry board. It's not exactly the most fancy. So what we'll do with this is we'll just take the cord here, and you can see that it's kind of like a little cutout there. We're just going to bend that up just like that, and then we can pull the cord through. Now, we're not going to be able to pull the cord all the way through because it does have a block there, and you know the hole isn't big enough. So we'll leave it like this and just toss it in the water like that, since the water is not going to go through the cable, but that'll give it a nice soak. So make sure you got those two pieces out of the water. Then we'll focus on this part here. You'll see that you have a button right there. We'll just throw that in the water, and then you've got the actual design here. So we'll just pull out the actual joystick, leaving the top part here. Now the rubber does sometimes brittle over time, and it'll break off, which will leave you with something like this. So that's a very common problem that you see with these controllers, but this one's intact, so we'll just throw this in the water as it is, and the same thing with this. And that's pretty much how you dismantle one, so let's just go ahead and give it a good clean. After we've cleaned it and it's had time to dry, we're going to put it back together again. And of course, we're going to start with this. And just want to make sure that there's no moisture inside of this tube here. Because basically that'll, start to drip down into the circuit board, and we do not want that. So just take a Q-tip and go in and make sure that that is completely dry. And it seems to be pretty good. So then we'll take this, and again we'll just make sure that there isn't any more moisture left anywhere. So that was fairly... Yeah, there's a lot of moisture down here, so we'll get rid of that. So looks to be good. Yeah. There we go. And then we'll push that through, and then we're gonna have basically this little nod here symbolizes up. So that's going to point, to the top here. So we'll just put that in, just like that. Put the button in. And again, there's always some moisture trapped inside of here. So we'll get rid of that. And then push that through. Now, I noticed that as I was taking this apart, it actually missed, it was missing the spring that's usually there, so I just took that from a faulty controller, and we're going to put that on there, just like that. That's what, makes it bounce back. And then we'll put that here for now and pull the cord through here. And now you can get a better view of that hole there. So you just want to put it through there until it reached the pivot point, and then just pivot it into the socket right there, just like that. And then we'll take the circuit board here, and we're going to put it so you have the circuits going towards the buttons, because these are basically like push pads. So as you're moving the joysticks and push the button, they'll hit these contact points. And that's how the whole system works. So we'll just line that up like that. And then we're going to align this as well. So just like that. And then just slide the whole thing. There. Can be a little tricky sometimes. So there we go. And then let's see if we can do it correctly this time. So let's see here. Make sure we don't pinch the cord anywhere. That looks good. So there you go. And now you can see that that button is actually jumping back out like it should. And then screw in the screws. There we go. And then, again, there's always a moisture in this little hole here, so we'll just take that out as also. There we go. And then just finish the whole thing with some orange pledge. Basically what this does, it kind of gives the controller a nice shine, but it also protects it. So dust has a harder time of clinging to it. At least for a short time after you apply this, but you can already see how, you know, it's getting its shine back basically. So orange pledge is just one of the many tricks that you can apply to make your controllers and consoles look pretty much brand new. And then we'll also do the cord, especially on these older generation consoles and controllers. The cords tend to be full of grime and muck as well. So we'll just do that as well. So yeah, you can see there. So that's pretty much how you clean one of these. You can see there's a huge difference from before and after. So again, I just want to say thank you so much for checking out my video. Please like, subscribe, and all of that good stuff. And I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.